And these are today's shoutouts. If you want to see yourself in the next video, then subscribe and leave a comment. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, Arca here, and I'd like to ask you a favor. If you find this video useful, please do make sure to subscribe to my channel. Help me grow, and I'm starting to gift subscribers. More info at the end of the video. Please enjoy. Yo, what is up, guys? Today we're gonna cover a very good topic that a lot of you requested in the comments, and it's how to play better on console. Now, I have a lot of guides on my channel that cover the best controller settings, tips and tricks for building on controllers, and stuff like that. These videos will be useful to watch after this one because they go into a lot of depth and different techniques and game styles you could be using to improve your game. This video will cover the general gameplay perspective and things you can do yourself to improve. Unlike keybinds and controller settings, this video will cover what you can do as a player. So, as always, before this video starts, I'm a new channel under 20 videos, 1 month on YouTube. I'm getting a lot of support and love right now, and it's amazing. So if you haven't yet subscribed, then please do so, as I'm doing a giveaway next week, and I'm also a one-man team that's making daily high-quality content for you guys, so your support would be awesome. If you want to improve, the last thing you'd want is for PC players to be in your lobby. They will have 4 times more FPS than you and play on 240Hz, and they will try their best to shut you down. Playing competitive events like daily duo cups is great because they are platform specific. You will play against other console players on them, and that is what you want. There is also a solo FNCS Invitational going on. You can compete in the qualifier games right now if you're fast enough and try your luck in actual competitive games. This is gonna do tremendous work for your building skills and helping you improve really fast. Because when you're playing in a competitive league, it's either you start grasping the skills a lot faster and being focused a lot more, or it's you just dying and that's it. So this is like pushing yourself on the edge scenario. You're pushing yourself into a high-end game to quickly get that momentum going and master the game right from the get-go. Okay, so you might be scrolling this video sometime in the future and these events are already gone and you can't queue up to play strictly against other console players. Those events also run on specific dates or times, and that doesn't help you if you want to pop in on your own at your own time and play a couple of games. But what can be useful for just that is Discord servers. Yeah, Discord community servers that offer full lobby scrims. They will be filled with guys just like you that want to improve in Fortnite on a specific platform. You have them servers for both PC and console, but a lot more and popular for console players, because you can guess how PC players will be with their 240Hz and 400fps smooth gameplay. Okay, so what you want to do is go into your Discord server tab and search for Fortnite custom games or scrim servers. Try to find a popular one to actually find populated lobbies. It might also sound like a lot of work, like you're connecting with random players through Discord on only your platform, and you're all going to create a custom game to run around and shoot people, but that does actually exist and it's quite popular. And that's because console players just don't want to play with PC players who play with controller. I think these Discord communities will be booming with even more players now, so the best time to hop on would be now. We talked about a couple of points in this video, but you might have noticed all of them being only about one thing, and that's platform specific lobbies. Well, believe it or not, if you want to improve on console, that means you'll be a new or casual player. Your skill won't be top notch, and because of how consoles are, you're gonna be locked in at 60Hz, going up against PC players with 144 and 240Hz monitors. It will be not worth your while. I really truly believe that the best way to improve on a specific platform is to play solely against that platform. PC players will do things that console players can't. It can work both ways when you're improving on one thing. Don't really care about what advantages you may hold over players on the other platform. You're just trying to get good on console. I'm an advocate for Epic stopping cross-platform play on a competitive level. And if you know your keybinds, building tips, aiming settings and tricks on the controller, this video would have covered your last point you were missing, and it's gameplay. Understanding what to play and how to play, it will reinforce all the skills you need to be good. I hope this video helped you guys even a little bit, because if it did, then please hit that like button. It really shows me your support for making this content. I'm a one-man team making daily videos for you, and by you showing your appreciation, I get all the motivation I need to keep these videos going. I'm doing a stream giveaway next week, so don't miss it. It's only available for my subs, so if you haven't yet subscribed, hey, right now would be a great time to do so. That's all from me for today. I hope I'll see you guys in the next video tomorrow. See you later. Hey guys, this is the end of the video. I hope you enjoy and find it useful. If you want to join my future Battle Pass and V-Box giveaways, do make sure to easily apply by subscribing and leaving a comment with your Fortnite username. I will be choosing 5 random people in the near future for weekly gifts.